Hello YouTube, Safer7 here, and welcome back to my Let's Play of Creeper World Anniversary Edition. Last time we did that mission. So let's go on to the next world, Draco, which seems to be some sort of crater or volcano. Draco, this world was barely inhabitable before the Creeper got here. Now it's just a horror to behold. Get us off this rock as quickly as you can, Commander. Scanners do show another artifact. Try to pick it up, but don't let it delay our escape. We're perched on the edge of a giant caldera. The idea of being caught in a creeper volcano sends shivers down my spine. Alright, so we've got four emitters here and two up here. Over here is an artifact. So let's start by creating ourselves a nice little network here. It's a decent amount of power to run us a good couple of blasters. In Creeper World 3, you can just click and drag, which is so much easier. Now we're gonna run on up to here. Gate and get us another blaster. And let's unpause and start the map, shall we? Now this map is infinitely easier than the last one. So hopefully we'll get out of here in a good enough time. So how's everybody out there in the YouTube world doing? I'm doing quite well myself. It's good to be back and recording again. It's been far too long, I think. We've got plenty of power going on now. 1.7. So we're maintaining a little bit of a positive there. Something that's kind of annoying is that it does kind of pulse a bit when you're building in a straight line. Let's see. Now, Creeper moves a lot slower in this than Creeper World 3, which is what I'm more used to playing. Oh boy, I can't wait to get to that one. Okay, we've got our first blaster online up here. That's really all we need to beat back this one particular caldera. Get our first packet speed up here. Honestly, the most devastating thing for this map would be a mortar, because it would keep this from going out any further than the level that the mortar's range is in. Is that on the same level? No, it's not. Yeah, see, just this one blaster is kind of backing this off. Don't think we can leave the map until we collect this. Here I am thinking about leaving the map already. Nah, this game's just started. Speed upgrade going. start working, because we need a much larger energy base to keep this going. As you can tell, we've got so much of this map covered in green already, and it's barely keeping these two blasters going. Once this blaster gets built, it should cut down significantly because it's not creating four or five different objects. Sure. Let's go ahead and start connecting this rift totem here. Get that on me. Speed upgrade. We're gonna need about 5 or 6 of these to get any decent use out of them. Put my blaster forward here. Start working on the little artifact we gotta get. Building up here. And how are we doing? A little bit of a deficit, but I don't think it's going to last all that long. I've been doing this one pretty conservatively. And once again, you can play this game fairly conservatively and still have a nice, chill, laid-back experience. Which is one of the reasons why I like this game so much. I'm really not doing all that much rushing. It doesn't behoove me to do so. I am going to start still building speed upgrades anyways, just because I do want to have this video not last 45 minutes like the last one. I assure you that those are going to be fairly rare. I've got 3 maps that will take that one to be, and we've already done one. Start. Okay, what just blew up? Okay, I overstated myself there a little bit. Whoops. Yeah, I don't think that's going to do. The artifact is a bit of an enigma. Our scientists will have to analyze it for some time before we can learn anything. Therefore, I don't think that blaster's gonna make it. And I got a little bit too big for my bridges there. Let's see if I have this fire off into the Caldera. Stop this from expanding. This up here. Yeah, okay, I think we've got this back under control. Phew. Not enough, the creeper's starting to eat into the blaster. Yeah, I think that's a lost cause. Should just affect it here. After this blaster gets built, we should be ready to start building mortars. Spin that, get us a little bit more energy collection. Okay, there we go, we've got that blaster put down, so it should start beating the creeper right now. To reach into the deeper bit of the caldera. And one up on either of these corners to start pushing things back. Yeah, look at this. It's starting to be digged up pretty good already. There's that speed upgrade built, so let's go with the fifth one here. The fourth. Wow, I cannot count. So, what's been going on in your world, YouTube? Is there any interesting topics that you want to discuss? I know I've done some, like, social commentary in the past, but I always thought it was too cringy, but let me know if you want me to hear me start talking about drama and social stuff, because I will. Other than that, I'm just kind of hard to both comment and play the game at the same time, so please forgive me if I do get a little quiet at times. It's not really that my intention to do so. This is a good training for me for just learning how to speak publicly and more confidently. Which is something I'll admit I was confused with. It's good to get some practice anyway. Oh, look at this stuff back off. I think I'm just done with this map already. 16 mission time, that's not too bad. Typically about 12 minutes before we finish this map out. So we keep building the speed upgrades. You see, one blaster is meant to just kind of suppress the speed. In this game, one blaster is enough to suppress any emitter. Let's go ahead and get ourselves a bit more energy going on here. Two building at the same time. That's what's going on. That's why I'm seeing a little bit of a slowdown. And we're also charging up the rip totems as well. Here. And this to suppress the next level of it. Just keep it on that and just do every mission as its own separate video regardless of the length from now on. So with that, I'd like to thank everybody for watching. I'm Safer7, out.